السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome back to Quranic Language Made Easy. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Today's topic is Lafif. So we are going to learn about the last irregularity, which is Lafif. And the previous irregularities we have already covered. You can refer to our previous lessons, or you can just go and type Mithal and QLME on YouTube and you'll get this, or you can just go to Quranic Language Made Easy and then go to playlist, this button, and then you can click on this Arabic verbs unit 2. Okay, unit 1, it consists of nouns, and unit 2 has all the verbs. So you can just go on and it's in order from lesson 1 all the way until down. And all the weak verbs are at the end, all the way from here. Mithal, and then Ajwaf, Naqis, and then Lafif. So in this video, we are going to discuss about Lafif verbs and its types. And Lafif Madi Mudare and Amr charts and Nahi charts with Quranic examples, Jazima and Nasiba, and also the active and passive participles, the doer and the subject, or the Mafa'ul and the object. And about the Masdar and Madi Majhul and Mudare Majhul chart with examples, difference between the two types of Lafif and its families, and difference between Mithal, Ajwaf, Naqis, and Lafif, the weak verbs. So this is what we are going to learn in today's lesson, inshallah. So Mithal Wawi is on lesson 23, unit 2, and Mithal Yai is on lesson 24, and Ajwaf Wawi and Ajwaf Yai and Ajwaf with Alif, it's from lesson 19 to 21, and Naqis starts from lesson 24 to 27. On YouTube, you can search all the previous lessons. And surf irregularities happen when there is a vowel or weak letter, waw or ya, in the root letters. Things to keep in mind that the waw and ya are the only root letters. And alif maqsura are never root letters. If you have those in the verb, then it is either a waw or a ya. Okay? I'll give a brief overview of these weak verbs which we have already covered. Mithal, the first irregularity is Mithal, the second is Ajwaf, and the third is Naqis. What is Mithal? Mithal is when the first root letter is a waw or a ya, then the word is classified as Mithal. And there are two types of Mithal. Mithal Wawi, the example is Wa'ada, Ya'idu, and Mithal Yai, Ya'isa, Ya'asu. In case of Wa'ada, the root letters are waw, Ain, and Dal. Notice that the first root letter is a vowel. The second type of irregularity is Ajwaf. When the second root letter is a waw or a ya, the word is classified as Ajwaf. Then the three types of Ajwaf are Ajwaf Wawi, and the example is Qala Yaqulu. The root letter are Qaf, Waw, and Lam. Notice that the middle letter is a vowel. And Ajwaf Wawi is Zada Yazidu. And Ajwaf with Alif is Khafa Yakhafu. And the last type of irregularity or the weak verb is Naqis. Naqis is when the third root letter is a waw or a ya. The word is classified as Naqis. An example, and there are four different types of Naqis. The first one is Naqis Wawi. Example, da'a, yada'u. The root letters are dal, ayn, and waw. Notice that the last root letter is a vowel. Naqis yai is hada, yahdi. And Naqis, the third type is sa'a, yasa'a. And the last type of Naqis is laqiya, yalqa. Lafif is the last irregularity. Lafif literally means tangled or complicated. Surf irregularities happen when there is a vowel or weak letter, waw or ya, in the root letters. When a word have two weak letters as the root letters, then the word is classified as Lafif. When two out of three root letters are vowels, that irregularity is called as Lafif. And these verbs have two weak letters, that is huruf illa, and only one strong consonant, which is harf sahiha. And this Lafif is further divided into two types. The first type is Lafif mafruq. The word mafruq literally means separated. The root word is faraqaf, farq. Farq means to separate, farq karna in Urdu, that also means to separate. And this is because the two vowels are separated. And here, the root letters 1 and 3 are vowels or weak letters. So here the word is considered as Lafif Mafruq when the first and the last root letters are vowels and the middle letter is a harf sahiha, a strong consonant, like waqa yaqi, which means to protect. In other words, this irregularity combines Mithal and Naqis. So what are the rules of مثال? For example, the example of مثال is وعد يعيد, right? So واو disappears in the مضارع. And in case of ناقص, where the last root letter is a weak letter, like دعا يدعو, right? Instead of يدعوه. So when the first and the third root letters are vowels, the word is classified as لفيف مفروق. And the example is وقع يقي, which means to protect. Notice that the first and the third root letters are vowels. And the two vowels are separated by a قاف. Second type is لفيف مقرون. The word is classified as لفيف مقرون when the second and the third root letters are vowels. The word مقرون comes from the root letter قاف را نون, قرن, which indicates closeness. The two vowels are side by side at the end. The word مقرون literally means paired together. So the two vowels are side by side at the end, and this is because the two vowels are paired together. And this type of word behaves just like ناقص. Okay, so here the root letters, the second and the third root letters are weak letters. For example, كوى يكوي, to smooth out. And then we have the root letters are كاف, واو, and يا. As we all know, when the middle root letter is a weak letter, then that is considered as أجوف. But in this case, in لفيف, when there are two weak letters next to each other, then the first vowel, the واو, it behaves normally. And it doesn't follow the أجوف rules. And this word is considered as لفيف مقرون when the second and the third root letters are vowels. And this type of word behaves just like ناقص. And we have the examples are كوى يكوي. The root letters are كاف, واو, and يا. And notice that the second and the third root letters are vowels, and these two vowels are together. And the rules of ناقص applied, not the أجوف. Now let's learn the different types of لفيف. We all know لفيف has two types, لفيف مفروق and لفيف مقرون. And لفيف مفروق belong to two families. The first one is ضرب يضرب. And the example for that is وقع يقي. Okay? So here we have وقع ضرب and يقي يضرب. And لفيف مفروق also belong to حسب يحسب family. And the example for that is وليا يلي. And notice here, like حسب, it's وليا. And يحسب, it's يلي, to befriend. And لفيف مقرون, this also belong to two families. The first one is ضرب يضرب. For example, we have طوى يطوي. And notice the difference between these two. لفيف مفروق ضرب يضرب وقع يقي. Because the first and the last root letters are weak letters. But in case of مقرون, even though it belongs to ضرب يضرب, طوى يطوي, the second and the third root letters are the weak letters. لفيف مقرون also belong to سميع يسمع family. For example, هوية يحوى, which mean to desire. Now let's take the ماضي chart for the first type, that is لفيف مفروق, which belongs to family ضرب يضرب. And the example is واو قاف and يا, وقع. Okay? And it is وقع وقيا وقو. And since it is وقع, the plural would be وقو. وقت وقتا وقينا. وقيتا وقيتما وقيتم. وقيتي وقيتما وقيتن. وقيتو وقينا وقينا. And وقع is to protect. He protected, they both protected, they all protected. And the example is أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فمن الله علينا ووقعنا عذاب السموم. But Allah conferred favor upon us and protected us from the punishment of the scorching fire. So وقعنا is third person masculine singular. And then we have ووقعهم عذاب الجحيم. And he will protect them from the punishment of the hellfire. This is again third person masculine singular, هو وقع. Now let's take the ماضي chart for the second type, that is لفيف مفروق, that belong to حسب يحسب family. And the example for that is وليا. وليا, وليا, ولو. And notice it's not ولو, it's gonna be ولو. It was وليو, there's no U sound and they make it ولو. Remember our لقيا, لقيا, it was لقو. Same way, it's gonna be ولو. وليت, وليتا, ولينا. وليتا, وليتما, وليتم. وليتي وليتما وليتن. وليتو ولينا ولينا. Now let's take the third type, لفيف مقرون, that belong to ضرب يضرب family. طوى يطوي. طوى طويا طووا. It's أو sound. طوت طوتا طوينا. طويتا طويتما طويتم. طويتي طويتما طويتن طويتو طوينا طوينا. And the Quranic examples are وَعَسَىٰ آدَمُ رَبَّهُ فَغَوَىٰ. And Adam disobeyed his Lord and erred. So what type of lafif is غَوَىٰ? Is it lafif مَفْرُوق or مَقْرُون? Look at the root letters carefully. غَيْن, وَاو, يَا are the root letters. And وَاو, آر and يَا are next to each other. So yes, you're right, it is مقرون. أُولَٰئِ الَّذِينَ أَغْوَيْنَا أَغْوَيْنَاهُمْ كَمَا غَوَيْنَا. These are those whom we led astray. We led them astray as we were astray. So أَغْوَيْنَا is from form 4. Inshallah, we are going to learn this in unit 3. So here, غَوَيْنَا is first person plural. نَحْنُ. Now let's learn the مُضَارِع. Present or future tense. Let's take the first type, that is لَفِيف مَفْرُوق, that belong to ضَرَبَ يَدْرِبُ family. That is وَقَى. Right? So the root letters are waqa, waw, kaf and ya. If you make it into a mudare, then it's gonna be the rules of mithal and naqis both apply here, right? So if it is waqa, then the mudare would be yauqiyu, right? But as per the mithal rules, the waw drops and it becomes yaqiyu, right? But there is no u sound in Arabic, so it becomes yaqi. Okay, so we have yaqi, yaqiyani, yaquna. It was supposed to be what? Yaqiyuna. There's no u sound, so they make it smooth. It's yaquna. He protects or he will protect. They both protect or they will protect. And then we have taqi, taqiyani, yaqina. Taqi, taqiyani, taquna. Taqina, taqiyani, taqina. So notice here taqina and taqina are same. So this is anti and this is antunna. Okay. And we have aqi, naqi and naqi. Example is وَجَعَلَ لَكُمْ سَرَابِيلَ تَقِيكُمُ الْحَرَّ وَسَرَابِيلَ تَقِيكُمْ بَأْسَكُمْ. So here we have and has made for you garments to protect you from the heat and garments to protect you from the mutual violence. So we have تَقِيكُمْ, third person feminine singular. And then we have لَفِيف مَفْرُوق, the second type which belong to حَسِبَ يَحْسِبُ family. We have وَلِيَ, يَلِي. We have يَلِي, يَلِيَانِ, يَلُونَ. تَلِي, تَلِيَانِ, يَلِينَ. تَلِي, تَلِيَانِ, تَلُونَ. تَلِينَ, تَلِيَانِ, تَلِينَ. It should have been تَلِينَ. And then we have أَلِي, نَلِي and نَلِي. There's a mistake, it's talina here. And then we have the third type, lafif maqroon, that belong to daraba yadribu family, that is tawa yatvi. Like hada yahdi, yatvi, yatviyani, yatvuna, tatvi, tatviyani, yatvina, tatvi, tatviyani, tatvuna, tatvina, tatviyani, tatvina. And tatvina, tatvina are same. Atvi, natvi and natvi. And the example is يَوْمَ نَطْوِ السَّمَاءَ كَطَيِّ السِّجْلِ لِلْكُتُبِ. The day we will fold the heaven like the folding of a scroll for records. So we have نَطْوِ, we will fold, first person, نَحْنُ. وَإِن يَسْتَغِيثُ يُغَاثُ بِمَاءٍ كَالْمُحْلِ يَشْوِ الْوُجُوهِ. So we here we have sheen, wow, ya are the root letters and yashwi. وَإِنَّ مِنْهُمْ لَفَرِيقًا يَلْؤُونَ أَلْسِنَتَهُمْ بِالْكِتَابِ. So here we have and indeed among them surely is a group, they distort their tongues in reciting the book. So here we have يَلْؤُونَ and the root letters are لَام, وَاو and يَا. Okay, لَوَا, يَلْوِي. Now look at these ayahs very carefully, pay attention to this. And in this these ayahs sometimes you see لَا تَحْوَى, لَا تَحْوَى and sometimes you see مِنَ النَّاسِ تَحْوِي, right? Or here, أَوْ تَحْوِي, right? So sometimes you see the مُضَارِع as تَحْوَى and sometimes you see as تَحْوِي. هَا, وَاو and يَا have come in the Quran in different families. Sometimes you see the same root letter coming in different families. For example, if you look at the ayahs, you see the difference. And here, this is because تَحْوَى belong to a different family. تَحْوَى belong to سَمِيعَ يَسْمَعُ family. Like هَوِيَ يَحْوَى, like how we had لَقِيَ يَلْقَى النَّاقِس. And تَحْوِي, this belong to ضَرَبَ يَدْرِبُ family. Like هَدَى يَحْدِي النَّاقِس. So even though the root letters are same, their meanings are different and their مَادِي and مُضَارِع are different because they both belong to two different families. For this, you need to look up in Hansware dictionary. And when I look, I found hawa yahwi. And this belonged to which family? Daraba yadribu family. Like hada yahdi in naqis. And hawa had this meaning to drop, fall, tumble, fall down, come down. And next one I found is hawiya yahwa. And this belonged to family sami'a yasma'u. Like laqiya yalqa. Right? And when I looked in Hans where I found the meaning is to love or become fond of. And the Quranic example is إِن يَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا الظَّنَّ وَمَا تَحْوَلْ أنفس. So here we have and what their souls desire. So we have tahwa. What family this belong? Hawiya yahwa. You're right. This belong to Sami'a yasma'u family. And next the amr or command. So the steps are you take the second person mudare taqi and you drop the alamat mudare ta and becomes qi. And next step is to make it madzoom. How do you make the weak words madzoom? By dropping the weak letters. So in case of this, you drop the ya and it becomes qi. So subhanallah in Arabic, just a single letter which is used as a command. And the first type is lafif mafruq which belong to daraba yadribu family. It becomes taqi, becomes qi. Qiya. And qu, protect, you both protect, you all protect. Qi, qiya, and qina for the feminine. And the Quranic examples are waqina azab an-nar. This you say it in your duas almost every single day, right? And save us from the punishment of the fire. Now you know it's not waqina the whole word. Waw is and, qi is a command from waqa yaqi. And na is the pronoun of first person. So and save us from the punishment of the fire. وَقِهِمْ عَذَابَ الْجَهِيمِ and save them from the punishment of the hellfire. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوْ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا so O you who believe, protect yourselves and your families from the fire. قُوْ it's plural, second person. أَنْتُمْ and the second type, لَفِيف مَفْرُوق that belong to حَسِيبَ يَحْسِبُ that is وَلِيَ يَلِي would be لِي لِيَا لُو لِي Liya, Lina. And the third type is that belong to Daraba Yadribu family would be Tawa Yatwi. It becomes Itwi, Itviya, Itwu. In this case, you have the Hamzatul Wasl, right? Because you cannot pronounce a word that's starting with a, that has a sukoon on it, right? So you need a Hamzatul Wasl. So Itwi, Itviya, Itwina. And now we have the prohibition that is forbidding. And you take the second person mudare and you make it majzum because of law of prohibition. So taqi with the ya just becomes la taqi. Okay. So again, lafif mafruq that belong to daraba yadribu would be la taqi, la taqiya, la taqu. Don't protect. You both don't protect. You all don't protect. La taqi, la taqiya, la taqina for the feminine. And second type is lafif mafruq that belong to hasiba yahsibu family would be la tali. لا تليا لا تلو لا تلي لا تليا لا تلينا ضرب يضرب طوى يتوي it's gonna be لا تتوي without a يا لا تتويا لا تتوو لا تتوي لا تتويا لا تتوينا and the Quranic examples are ولا تنيا في ذكري so here and do not slacken in my remembrance and the root words are واو نون and يا ونا يني okay so تنيا so this is second person dual And we have kullama ja'ahum rasulum bima la tahwa anfusahum. So la tahwa anfusahum. So there's no change. So what type of la is this? This is not law of prohibition. This is law of simple negation. There's no change. And we have one more example. إِذْ تُسَعِدُونَ وَلَا تَلْؤُونَ عَلَىٰ أَهْدٍ And again here we have law of simple negation that will not make any change to the mudare. And تَلْؤُونَ the root letters are lam, waw and ya. Now let's see the jazima or the jassif particles. What are they? They are li, la, lam, lamma, in, wal, and fal. So normal version would be yasma'u in light or the mansub would be yasma'a and the lightest would be yasma with a sukoon. So in case of jazima, lightest version, you get rid of the vowel altogether. Okay. And here, so we have yaqi, it becomes yaqi. And the example is وَإِن تَلْؤُوا أَوْ تُعْرِدُوا And if you distort or refrain. So تَلْؤُونَ, right? The noon is dropped. And here we have وَقِهِمُ السَّيِّئَاتِ وَمَنْ تَقِ السَّيِّئَاتِ يَوْمَئِذٍ So this is أَمَرْ وَقِهُمْ And then we have وَمَنْ تَقِ مَنْ is a conditional word because of that the ya is dropped. Okay, so it becomes تَقِ. Now the nasiba or the accusative particles are لِي كَيْ لِكَيْ لِكَيْ لَا أَنْ لِأَنْ أَلَّا حَتَّى and لَنْ In the example for nasibar, لِنَجْعَلَهَا لَكُمْ تَذْكِرَةً وَتَعِيَهَا أُذُنُ وَاعِيَا. تَعِيَهَا, right? Why is it ya with a mansoob, the root letter waw, ayn and ya? Because of li. Li is huruf nasiba here. Now the masdar, as you all know, masdar is not in the same pattern for the mujarrad small families. And we just take one pattern and stick it for the ease. And we are going to learn in details about the different masdar patterns at the in the next lesson, inshallah. That is the last lesson of unit 2. And the Quranic examples are tattabi'ul hawa. So al hawa, this is a noun because it starts with an al. So do not follow the desire. وَرَاعِنَا لَيَّن بِأَلْسِنَتِهِمْ وَتَعْنَن فِي الدِّينِ. So here we have لَيَّن. So the root letter is لام, واو and يَا. Right? So this is لَوَى, يَلْوِي. And لَيَّن is the مصدر. يَوْمَ نَطْوِي السَّمَاءَ كَطَيِّ السِّجِلِّ لِلْكُتُبِ. So here we have نَطْوِي and then we have طَيِّ, كَطَيِّ. Like the folding. So this is the مصدر. And then we have اللَّهُ وَلِيُّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And Allah is the guardian of the believers. So this is وَلِيَ, يَلِي, وَلِيُّ. Right, so this is guardian, masdar. وَمَنْ يُدْلِلْ فَلَانْ تَجِدَ لَهُ وَلِيَّمْ مُرْشِدًا. And whoever he lets go astray, then never you will find for him a protector, a guide. وَلِيَّنْ is the masdar. وَاتَّبَعُ الشَّهْوَاتِ فَسَوْفَ يَلْقَوْنَ غَيَّا. So this is غَيْن, واو and يَا. غَيَّا is the masdar. We have these active participles. So isam fa'il, they always follow the pattern of fa'in regardless of the family. Like da'a yad'u was da'in, hada yahdi was hadin, right? So same way, waqiyun, it becomes waqin. So da'in, da'iyan, da'in, hadin, hadiyan, hadin, laqin, laqiyan, laqin. So how we had this chart for isam fa'il, we have the same chart. I mean, it's pretty much the same for all these naqis and lafif. So it's gonna be waqin, waqiyani, waquna, waqiyan, waqiyaini, waqina, waqin, waqiyaini, waqina. So this is lafif mafruq that belong to daraba yadribu family. Notice that the rafa marfu waqin and the jar waqin, they both look exactly the same. But remember that this waqin is not the jar. Okay, this is actually rafa. This is marfu. The ya is dropped. The tanween at the end is only there to remind you that this was supposed to be waqiyun, you, right? But there's no u sound in Arabic. So the ya is removed and replaced with a tanween. And for rafif mafruq, hasiba yahsibu family, it's gonna be waliya yali. Walin, waliyani, waluna, waliyan, waliyaini, walina, waliyin, waliyaini, walina. The third type, lafif makroon, that belong to daraba yadribu family, tawa yatvi would be tawin, tawiyani, tawuna, tawiyan, tawiyaini, tawina, tawin, tawiyaini, tawina. And the Quranic examples are ma laka minallahi min waliyyun wala waq. So here we have for you against Allah any protector and not defender, waqin. So here waqin is rafa. Wama lahum minallahi min waqin. Again we have min waqin, this is jar because of min. Wama lahum min dunihi min walin. So we have walin here. And then we have إِذْ نَادَاهُ رَبُّهُ بِالْوَادِ الْمُقَدَّسِ طُوَى. So this is واو, دال and يَا are the root letters. وَمَا كُنْتَ ثَاوِيًا فِي أَهْلِ مَدْيَن. So we have ثَاوِيًا, ثَا, واو and يَا. فَكُبْكِبُوا فِيهَا هُمْ وَالْغَاؤُونَ. غَيْن, واو and يَا are the root letters. فَأَغْوَيْنَاكُمْ إِنَّا كُنَّا غَاوِينَ. So we have غَامِينَ. Okay, for the feminine chart, there's no change. Nothing is weird about it. The feminine chart is easier, like hadiyatun. The same way we have lafif mafruq for daraba yadribu families. Waqiyatun, waqiyatani, waqiyatun. Waqiyatan, waqiyataini, waqiyatin. Waqiyatin, waqiyataini, waqiyatin. And second type, lafif mafruq for hasiba yahsibu family is waliyatun, waliyatani, waliyatun. Waliyatan, waliyataini, waliyatin. Waliyatin, waliyataini, waliyatin. The third type for tawayatwi is tawiyatun, tawiyatani, tawiyatun, tawiyatan, tawiyataini, tawiyatin, tawiyatin, tawiyataini, tawiyatin. And the Quranic example are fa ummuhu haviya, his abode will be a pit, haviya. And then we have wattaiyaha udhunu wa'iya, waw ayn and ya, wa'iya. وانشقت السماء فهي يومئذ واهية. واو ها and يا are the root letters. So واهية. فهي خاوية على عروشها. So here we have خا واو and يا are the root letters. And the passive participles مفعول اسم مفعول always follow the pattern مفعوون. Right? So مدعوون or مهديون. Right? So it's gonna have the same chart as مهديون. So we have for لفيف مفروق ضرب يضرب family would be موقيون موقياني موقيونا موقيان موقييني موقيينا موقيين موقييني موقيينا. And for second حسيب يحسب family لفيف مفروق would be موليون موليياني موليونا موليان موليييني موليينا موليين موليييني موليينا. And for third type ضرب يضرب لفيف مقرون would be مطويون مطوياني مطويونا مطويان مطوييني مطويينا مطويين مطوييني مطويينا. And the feminine chart is same as مهديتن. The same way we have for ضرب يضرب is موقيتن موقيتاني موقياتن موقيتن موقيتين موقياتن موقيتن موقيتين موقياتن. For حسيب يحسب it's gonna be موليتن موليتاني موليتن موليتن موليتين موليتن موليتن موليتين موليتن. The third type is ضرب يضرب مطويتن مطويتاني مطوياتن مطويتن مطويتين مطوياتن مطويتن مطويتين مطوياتن. And the example is والسماوات مطويات بيمينه and the heavens will be folded in his right hand. And the ماضي مجهول would be like هديا. The same way we have وقيا. Okay, for لفيف مفروق ضرب يضرب family would be وقيا وقيا وقو وقيت وقيتا وقينا وقيتا وقيتما وقيتم وقيتي وقيتما وقيتن وقيتو وقينا وقينا. So instead of وقيو you sound it becomes وقو. And the second type for حسيب يحسب it's gonna be وليا وليا ولو وليت وليتا ولينا وليتا وليتما وليتم وليتي وليتما وليتن وليتو ولينا ولينا. And for لفيف مقرون ضرب يضرب family would be توفيا توفيا توفو توفيت توفيتا توفينا توفيتا توفيتما توفيتم توفيتي توفيتما توفيتن توفيتو توفينا توفينا. مضارع مجهول will also be the same like يهدى يهديانِ يهدونا. In the same way we have وقيا يوقى. Okay, so لفيف مفروق for ضرب يضرب مضارع مجهول would be يوقى يوقياني يوقونا توقى توقياني توقينا توقى توقياني توقونا توقينا توقياني توقينا. Notice توقينا and توقينا أنتين أنتنا are same. أوقى نوقى and نوقى. The second type حسيب يحسب would be يولى يولياني يولونا تولى تولياني يولينا تولى تولياني تولونا تولينا تولياني تولينا أولى نولى نولى. And the example is وَمَنْ يُوقَ شُحَّ نَفْسِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. And whoever is saved from the greediness of his soul, then those, they are the successful ones. So يُوقَ is third person masculine singular. This is مضارع مجهول. Third type is لفيف مقرون which belong to ضرب يضرب family. طوى يطوي becomes يطوى يطوى يطوياني يطوونا تطوى تطوياني يطوينا تطوى تطوياني تطوونا تطوينا تطوياني تطوينا. These two are same. اتوى نتوى and نتوى. Now let's take example of اسم التفضيل. We have النبي أولى بالمؤمنين من أنفسهم وأزواجه أمهاتهم. And then we have أولى, right? The prophet is closer to the believers, right? Than their own selves and his wives and their mothers. Subhanallah. بعدهم أولى ببعد في كتاب الله. And some of them are nearer to one another in the book of Allah. We have الذين استحق عليهم الأوليان فيقسمان بالله. So this is dual. Those who have a lawful right over them, the former two, and let them both swear by Allah. And we have the noun لا شيء فيها, no blemish in it, absolutely no blemish in it. And the root letters are واو, شين and يا. Let's learn the surf chart. Surf is the study of word patterns and how meaning can be derived based on these patterns. And we have ماضي مضارع مصدر and فاعل, ماضي مجهول مضارع مجهول مفعول, and then we have أمر النهي. So the first type is لفيف مفروق that belong to ضرب يضرب family. وقى يقي وقي واق وقيا يوقى موقي. لا تقي. This is the surf صغير, the small surf, and this is surf صغير, like you know ماضي وقع, the whole chart is here, وقع وقيا وقو, the whole chart, and يقي يقيا يقي يقياني يقونا, right? So the whole chart, this is surf كبير, you have everything in this chart. And the second type is لفيف مفروك, that belong to حسيبة يحسب family, is وليا يلي ليون, والن وليا يولا مولي لي لا تلي. So this is surf صغير chart. And we have لفيف مقرون for ضرب يدرب family is طوى يطوي طي طاو طوي يطوى مطوي اطوي لا تطوي. And this is the surf كبير chart, the big chart for the طوى يطوي. And we have لفيف مقرون which belong to سميع يسمع family is the fourth type. I didn't make the chart ماضي and مضارع separate chart for this fourth type which belong to سميع يسمع. It's هوية يهوى, and it's هاون هوية يهوى محوي. And there's one more example is عيية عيية عيو. It's very funny to say this عييت عييتا عيينا. So this is the surf كبير chart. Only exception in لفيف مقرون when the both the root letters are ياد, similar root letters. Remember the مضاعف rule, when the two similar letters are next to each other they fuse together and they have a شدة on it. So instead of عييا they can also say عييا. So they can also say حييا يحيا, or they can also say instead of حييا they can say حييا. Alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah, we are done with all our irregularities for the mujarrad families, that is the small six families, like nasara yansuru, daraba yadribu, samia yasmau, fataha yaftahu, hasiba yasibu, and karuma yakrumu, right? So there is more to it. We have to still learn about the irregularities for the mazid fi are the big families. So inshallah we will be learning about the mazid fi or the big families or different forms, form 1 to form 10 in our unit 3 shortly inshallah. And there is only one last chapter remaining in Quranic language made easy book, that is masdar for unit 2. Inshallah I'll try to post a video about that soon, and that will be the end of unit 2 altogether. And jazakallahu khairan for watching. There are some possibilities that there could be mistakes in my video. If you find any, please correct it and let me know in the comment section. Or if you have any questions or comments or suggestions, you can reach me out at qlme2017@gmail.com. Jazakallahu khairan.